Hello everyone, my name is Taboo Conspiracy, and I'm a Flat Earther. As I've said before, I believe that Flat Earth is the key to ending our physical, mental, scientific, educational, financial, and spiritual enslavement. That's the only reason why I'm here, and that's why I'm passionate about the Flat Earth, and that's why the anti-truthers are trying so hard to shut us down. My topic for this presentation is, what does it mean to be a Flat Earther? We know that the media would proclaim that flat earthers are just stupid or uneducated, holding on to unproven, antiquated beliefs. Well, I have a bachelor's, a juris doctorate, and a master's, and many other flat earthers also have advanced degrees. We have PhDs, engineers, pilots, military professionals, lawyers, surveyors, and teachers. Okay, so maybe we have the same formal education, but maybe we flat earthers are just ignorant of the heliocentric model. Surprisingly, nearly every flat earther knows more about the heliocentric model than your typical ball earther. We're going to have a little quiz here. Let's see how good you flat earthers are at restating heliocentric dogma without looking up the answers. Question 1. How fast does the ground of the Earth allegedly rotate at the equator? Approximately 1,000 miles per hour. Question 2. How fast is the alleged Earth's orbit around the Sun? 66,600 miles per hour. Question 3. How far away is the Sun purportedly from the Earth? 93 million miles. Question 4. How are seasons caused according to the heliocentric model? Because the Earth is tilted. Question 5. How many degrees is the alleged axial tilt of the Earth? 23.4 degrees or 66.6 degrees, depending on how you want to view it. Question 6. How far away is the moon, allegedly? From surface to surface, it would be 234,000 miles. Question 7. What is the radius of the alleged ball Earth and what is its circumference? Radius equals 3,959 miles. Circumference, 25,000 miles. Question 8. What formula can you use to determine the rate at which the alleged ball Earth drops away from you? 8 inches per mile squared. Try to find any globe-loving audience anywhere that can answer those questions better. We flat earthers are certainly not ignorant of the heliocentric model. In fact, when you really think about the flying, vortexing heliocentric model, you begin to realize how stupid it really is. Since they try to obscure their actual beliefs, let me tell you what a ball earther believes. They believe all of the planets, moons, asteroids, meteors, and satellites of our solar system are chasing after the sun that is flying around our galaxy at a speed of 514,000 miles per hour. This video isn't scaled properly, but if you scale it properly with the sun having a diameter of just 1 centimeter on your computer screen, Pluto would then be outside your home 42 meters away from the sun. That's ridiculous. But what's even more crazy is the fact that they believe that all of the planets and moons of the solar system are all on this same plane of the sun as they chase after the sun. So, in a year time, the sun would have traveled in this left direction 4.5 billion miles in 1 year. However, planet Earth would have also traveled 4.5 billion miles chasing after the sun in the same left direction. But in addition, Earth would have simultaneously traveled up and down 584 million miles in an ellipse around the sun. If you're still struggling with the silliness of this, next time you're in a marathon, try sidestepping back and forth at great distances while simultaneously trying to keep up with the leader, and maybe you'll see the problem. Like I've said before, I don't care how many degrees you have. This is stupid. Ball earthers believe that a comet, like Halley's Comet, can get yanked back every 75 years and catch right back up with a zooming solar system right on schedule. That's stupid. They believe that even though the Earth is wobbling, spinning, and vortexing through the vacuum of space at insane speeds, that the North Star has never changed position in recorded history simply because it's really, really, really far away. That's stupid. They believe that all of the wobbling, spinning, and vortexing through space cannot be felt, measured, or detected on Earth. Einstein himself said there was no optical experiment that can detect the Earth's motion. That's stupid. They believe that the moon appears reddish during a lunar eclipse because the sunrises and sunsets of the Earth are refracting onto the moon 234,000 miles away. That's stupid. They believe that a selenilion occurs because the sun and moon, which are both above the horizon, somehow aren't really there but only appear there because of refraction, which strangely only happens during a lunar eclipse. That's stupid. They believe that the sun and moon only appear to be the same size in our sky, based solely on an impossible coincidence. To understand the scale of this, for a tall 7'2" man representing the diameter of the sun, the ball earther would claim that the moon would have a mere diameter of the eraser on a pencil. But from our point of view on the Earth, the sun and moon only appear to have the same diameter based solely on a coincidence. That's stupid. They believe that during a solar eclipse that the shadow of the moon, which is supposed to have a diameter of 2,159 miles, casts a shadow on Earth that is only 70 miles in diameter. That's stupid. They believe that our pressurized atmosphere is adjacent to an inconceivably powerful vacuum without any effect whatsoever on our air supply or anything else. That's stupid. They believe that the Earth curves away from you at 8 inches per mile squared based on a ball Earth radius of 3,959 miles, and yet all the evidence demonstrates that we see way too far and there is no measurable curvature. An Earth radius of 3,959 miles? That's stupid. Whether you're at the surface filming across a body of water or in an airplane with an infrared camera, they believe that you can see way too far because the atmosphere has this magical ability to remove all evidence of the curvature and wraps distant objects around the curvature. That's stupid. They want you to believe that if you were to stand on the west side of Utah Lake with binoculars, that the opposite eastern shore 13 miles away should be 70 feet below the horizon. That's stupid. They believe that all of our oceans are bendy and conform to the shape of a ball, but these bendy oceans simply disappear whenever you try to measure or detect them, and are certainly never encountered by naval forces. That's stupid. They believe that the bulge of the Earth can disappear and relocate many miles further while leaving objects in between unaffected, like in this infamous Black Swan video from BMLS B69. Relocating geometric horizons in Earth bulges while not affecting the objects in between? That's stupid. They believe that the only way to tell whether a distant boat is actually a mirage is by the curvature calculator. No, that boat is not a mirage. That is stupid. They believe in the story of the lunar lander, which looks like it was shoddily made by a high school drama club, complete with black paper, tape, gold aluminum foil, and curtain rods, which somehow achieved speeds up to 4,000 miles per hour on descent and ascent, was never tested or flown on Earth, somehow didn't leave a blast crater, included enough room for a fold-up dune buggy, and had a miraculous air conditioning and fresh air system that could sustain life on the moon for more than 3 days. That's stupid. They believe those visible wires above the Apollo astronauts were only light reflections, and that the obvious vertical movie backdrops visible throughout the Apollo missions were actually real moon landscapes, despite the obvious line between the stage and the backdrop. That's stupid. They believe that the alleged ISS spaceship, which most certainly looks like a kid's model, which was never assembled on Earth for testing, is actually falling perpetually at 17,000 miles per hour in the vacuum of space. That's stupid. They believe that the unproven force of gravity from the moon pulls the oceans towards the moon but has no effect on anything else but the oceans. That's stupid. In addition to the alleged gravity of the moon pulling the oceans, they believe that the moon causes high tides on the opposite side of the Earth by causing the Earth to bounce, which bulges the oceans away from the moon. That's stupid. They believe that the bright moonlight that you can read from is actually a reflection of sunlight 234,000 miles away off of a dark gray dust ball in total contradiction of the inverse square law of light. That's stupid. They believe in 19,287 space satellites, which are never photographed except for those ones attached to balloons. That's stupid. I don't know if you've ever taken the time to look at the supposed satellites deployed during the space shuttle, but the footage is actually pretty ridiculous. They believe that radio waves, VHF waves, sonar waves, radar waves, Lorentzi, and lasers all wrap around the Earth's curvature and can hop bulges of earth and water hundreds of miles high. That's stupid. They believe in the Coriolis force when it comes to field goal kicks, Foucault pendulums, and the direction of your toilet drain, but then want you to ignore the Coriolis force when you ask about Felix Baumgartner's balloon flight for 2.5 hours at an altitude up to 128,000 feet. Without question, the atmosphere evinces no properties of spin or being attached to the ground spinning 1,040 miles per hour, and to claim otherwise is stupid. They believe that because the Earth spins, that the Earth is bulged at the equator, that the solid ground can bulge, but nothing else is affected by the rotation of the Earth and its centrifugal forces. That's stupid. They believe that commercial surveyors, engineers, snipers, radar operators, pilots, military professionals shouldn't have to take into account the Earth's rotation or the supposed curvature, because for some reason the Earth's rotation and the curvature evade all detection and don't actually need to be considered. That's stupid. They believe it's perfectly normal for a woman astronaut's hair to be sculpted into the Bride of Frankenstein instead of flowing naturally, like wood in a true weightless environment. That's stupid. They believe that airplanes, regardless of speed or altitude, mysteriously tip their noses to automatically adjust for the mountains of curvature. That's stupid. They believe the geometric horizon drops as an observer rises, but ignore the fact that the horizon did not drop one iota as Felix Baumgartner got to 128,000 feet. That's stupid. They believe that the Antarctic Treaty and its enforcement protocols, which prevent all independent exploration below the 60th South Parallel, was only instituted to protect the environment. That's stupid. They believe that it's just some strange coincidence that there is no north-south circumnavigation. That's stupid. They believe the alleged ball planet of Pluto coincidentally happens to have an unmistakable Disney Pluto dog on it. That's stupid. They believe that the first photograph of Earth in 43 years just happened to have the word sex spelled in the clouds. That's stupid. They believe that supposed space rockets, like the space shuttle, arc and look like they're falling down only because the rocket is leveling out in space. That's stupid. They believe that you were accidentally created by rocks and ooze and that life really doesn't exist.
It's not okay to say that the Earth is flat. I keep getting this question. There's no such thing as life, really. That we're very complicated rocks. Uh-huh. And we're a chemical reaction that got complex enough to become conscious.
That's stupid. They believe that a high-precision gyroscope, which retains rigidity in space, somehow automatically corrects for both curvature and axial rotation. That's stupid. They believe that a volcanic plume, which can shoot straight up in the air, is somehow unaffected by the spin of the 1,000 mile per hour ground below it. That somehow, the upper layers of the plume speed up to keep up with the lower levels of the plume. That's stupid. They believe conformity is a virtue, parroting is intelligence, and any statements outside the approved narrative must be censored. That's stupid. To be clear, I'm not calling ball earthers stupid, but their irrational, unproven, silly beliefs, devoid of all evidence, are certainly stupid. And if you refuse to think for yourself and to investigate the flat earth with an open mind, that is stupid. Now that we've covered much of what a ball earther believes, what does a flat earther believe? I can't speak for everyone, but this is what I believe as a flat earther. Based on all of the evidence, I believe the Earth is a flat and motionless plane because all reasonable and objective tests that you can perform indicate the Earth is flat and stationary. These tests are repeatable, observable, and falsifiable by anyone. No presuppositions, no pseudoscience dogma, and no appeals to authority figures and conformity. Simply stated, the evidence supporting a flat and stationary Earth far outweighs the evidence of a whirling, twirling ball flying through the vacuum of space. As shown now by hundreds of videos and photographs, There is no measurable curvature, even though the curvature should be easily detectable with modern instruments and experienced in everyday life. Even at heights more than 121,000 feet, there's no curvature, and that belies everything we've been shown and told since we were children. I believe that geometric bulges of the ball Earth cannot disappear and relocate to present a false flat Earth and let us see or detect objects that should be hidden by mountains of curvature. I believe in honest skepticism and demand clear, rational, objective, demonstrable, testable, repeatable, and relevant evidence to prove the shape of our Earth. I believe the Earth is not in space, and that space, at least as it's widely understood, is fake. Space has been faked by NASA and all of the other fraudulent space agencies and their corporate subsidiaries, as shown by all the wires, ridiculous toy models, space bubbles, and many CGI mistakes. I believe the Apollo moon missions, which ended 48 years ago, were poorly faked, with 1960s movie props, wires, models, paintings, and obvious movie backdrops. Because NASA has faked space and the moon landings, I believe that NASA is a criminal organization stealing $62 million per day from the American taxpayer under false pretense. Astronauts are nothing more than poor actors who lie continually and should not be venerated by children. I believe that if NASA and their subsidiaries faked any of it, as the clear evidence shows, then we can rightfully assume that they fake all of it, which they do. That is the logical and right approach. I believe that it's impossible for a pressurized atmosphere to exist next to the unbelievably powerful vacuum of space. The vacuum of space, if it existed, would certainly kill us all. I believe that it's okay to theorize and speculate, but theories and speculations do not constitute fact, but are beliefs, and should never be stated as fact. I believe in a humble, true science based on the actual scientific method, which includes an independent variable that can be manipulated to change the dependent variable. And I certainly do not believe in dogmatic, top-down narratives. True science should welcome all questions and challenges. Because so much of science is now based on nothing but phony stories, blunders, and dogma, we must give science and academia a major overhaul. I do not believe in groupthink, but I believe in our own God-given individual intuition, reason, and logic. I believe every person must think for themselves, conduct their own objective research, and reach their own rational conclusions based on demonstrable evidence, and you'll never hear a ball earther tell you the same. I believe that institutionalized conformity is destroying humanity, and the evidence of our idiocracy is unfortunately becoming clearer every day. I believe it is our duty to share truth to the best of our ability. Finally, I believe in Jesus Christ. In fact, I love Christianity and the Bible. But I believe that any good and truth-loving individual from any background is welcome to my Flat Earth family. In conclusion, I can only advise what every Christian should know, and that is, prove all things, hold fast that which is good. May God bless you all in your pursuit of and sharing His truth. Merry Christmas.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord. as I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sinners, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sinners, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and